Hello friends, welcome back to STM32 tutorials. Myself Ajinkya and we are here to learn embedded system with STM32F103 controller. In the previous videos, we saw how to interface different components with GPIOs such as LED, LCD, 7 segment, key and keypad. In this video, we will see two important settings. First one is GPIO configuration and second one is clock configuration. What are the GPIO configuration parameters? We open STM32 CubeMX software, we click on certain GPIO pin and we set it as GPIO output. So what are the configuration parameters of this GPIO output? For that, you have to click on System Core, click on GPIO. Now on the right hand side, you can see the GPIO mode and configuration. So in the configuration, you can see pin name, signal on the pin, GPIO output level, GPIO mode, GPIO pull up pull down, maximum output speed and user label. So if you go through the option of these configurations, you can see that so GPIO output level can be set to low or high, GPIO mode can be set to push pull output or open drain output. In the GPIO pull up or pull down, you can set it to pull up or pull down. When the GPIO is set in push pull output mode, you can set the pull up or pull down to these options. So what are these settings? So let's understand these settings. If you look inside the datasheet of the STM controller, you will find the similar GPIO structure. We will only focus on the GPIO part. So we can see these GPIO configuration parameters in the STM32 CubeMX software. So we will first understand what is push-pull and what is open-drain output mode. In the push-pull output mode, there are two MOSFETs inside the microcontroller. One switch will be connected to ground and the other will be connected to VCC. When output goes to low, it is connected to ground through N-channel MOSFET. When output goes to high, it is connected to VCC through P-channel MOSFET. So when output is low, it is actively pulled to ground. And when output is high, it is actively pushed to VCC. So the name push-pull. You can see the two equivalent circuits. In open drain GPIO configuration, only one MOSFET is present, that is only N-channel MOSFET is there. The drain of the N-channel MOSFET is taken out of the IC. This configuration is active only in one direction. It can pull the output towards the ground, but it cannot drive it too high. When the N-channel MOSFET switch is off, the output is floating, and when the switch is on, the output is connected to ground through the N-channel MOSFET, so providing path for the current to flow. This configuration needs a pull-up resistor that is to be connected externally. This was all about the GPIO output mode. Now we will focus on this section, pull-up and pull-down. In digital circuits, pin must be connected to either logic high or logic low. It should not be left unconnected, that is floating. When pin is left floating, it can be in the undetermined state, that it can be either high or low or not both. The floating pin can cause many problems. To correct, connect a resistor from the signal line to VCC or ground. The resistor will either pull up the signal to VCC or it will pull down to ground. In ARM or any other microcontroller, they have built-in circuitry to do this. That way you don't need any external component. Another parameter is GPIO speed, which controls the slew rate, which decides the rise time and fall time of the output signal. It is a good practice to keep the slew rate slow and should be increased only when needed. Like GPIO output, GPIO input has similar settings. The GPIO input can be set as input with internal pull up, input with internal pull down, and input can be left floating. The input with internal pull up, the input signal will be pulled up to the VCC. When internal pull down is active, the input signal will be pulled down to ground. When the input is left floating, the signal level follows the external signal, and when no external signal is connected, the SMIT trigger in the controller toggles between the logic levels induced by the external noise on the pin. Thanks for watching the video. If you enjoy the video, hit like button, share and subscribe. We will see you in the next video.